Can we repair our damaged skin barrier by cleansing the right way? Let's find out how to cleanse our face to protect our skin barrier. Hey Wishtrenders, it's your sister Eunice here. In the last episode, we talked about the basics of skin barrier. In part two, we will find out how to cleanse our face in order to protect and repair our skin barrier. And in the third part, which will be uploaded next week, we will talk about ingredients that are effective for skin barrier repairing. So please look forward to it and stay tuned in. Round one, what is an acid mentle? The stratum corneum, which we explained in the first episode, is actually covered by a very thin and weak film called the acid mentle. The acid mentle is made up of sebum and sweat from the sebaceous glands and sweat glands. This acid mentle is the very first protective layer of our skin barrier. The acid mentle reduces the skin's inflammatory reactions and also helps to prevent the production of acne. In order for the acid mentle to protect our skin, a pH level of 4.5 to 5.5 is required. However, if the pH level falls out of this range due to whatever reason, the acid mentle becomes weaker, causing the skin barrier to get damaged, and furthermore, it can be the start of all the different skin concerns like we talked about in the first episode. If it is a healthy acid mentle that has a shift in pH levels, it will return to a normal pH level within 30 minutes. However, if it is a damaged skin barrier, it will take over 2 weeks for it to return to a normal pH level. And during those 2 weeks, the skin barrier will be exposed to more damages. So what can we do to normalize a damaged acid mentle? The answer is maintaining your skin at the pH level of 4 to 6. There are several causes of acid mentle to become damaged. But if you want to repair your acid mentle and strengthen your skin barrier, there's a first step that you must keep in mind. It's cleansing correctly. So, how do we cleanse our face to get it back to the pH level of 4 to 6? Let's find out. Round 2. How to choose the right cleanser for a damaged skin barrier. In order to repair a damaged acid mentle, there are a few things you need to keep in mind when choosing a cleanser. The first thing to look for is a cleanser with a low pH. Low pH cleansers usually have pH levels that are similar to our acid mentals, in the 4 to 6 range. The biggest difference between a low pH cleanser and a high pH cleanser is its cleansing ability. High pH cleansers such as soaps are alkaline. While they may be effective in removing oils and impurities from our skin, they also remove the natural oils that your skin produces. That's why high pH cleansers can be irritating and they aren't very good for your skin barrier. If the cleanser that you're currently using leaves your skin with a squeaky clean finish, that means that your acid mentle has probably already been removed to a certain extent. Using a high pH cleanser on oily skin that's healthy won't cause so many problems. However, if you have skin that needs repairing, high pH cleansers are the first thing to avoid. Low pH cleansers leave your skin feeling hydrated and won't leave your skin with a pooling sensation after cleansing. But just because your skin doesn't feel dry afterwards, it does not mean that you can skip your moisturizing step. We'll get into that deeper on our third episode, so don't go anywhere and stay tuned in. The next factor to check is the consistency of your cleanser. There are so many cleansers with different consistencies out there. What type of consistency do you have to use to regain a healthy acid mentle and skin barrier? Did you know that the consistency of your cleanser also has to do with your pH? The first type of consistency I want to recommend is an oil type. In order for a substance to have a pH level, it must contain water. But oil products don't have water, so that means that they do not have a pH. So by using an oil cleanser, it will leave a natural oil layer on top of the skin, which will protect your acid mentle. The second type of consistency is a balm type. And a balm type is just an oil type in a solid form. It has all of the pros an oil type cleanser has. The last type of consistency is a gel type. Gel type cleansers are a type of water-based cleansers that usually have a low pH. If oil or balm type of cleansers feel uncomfortable to use or you feel like they're not giving enough cleansing results as you want, we recommend using gel type of cleansers instead. Even if your cleanser isn't an oil, balm, or a gel type of cleanser, as long as it has a low pH level, they're safe to use for repairing your skin barrier. But if it's hard to find out what pH level your cleanser has, try using one of the products that includes one of the factors that we mentioned above. There's one more thing that you should look into, and that's micellar water. Micellar water is a gentle cleanser in a water form that doesn't have any alcohol, paraben, or sulfate ingredient. If the high pH level of water concerns you when cleansing, micellar water is a great substitute for you. So we learned about the cleansing options for you to repair and protect your skin barrier. So with these cleansing options, let's find out how we can repair our skin by cleansing for each of our skin types. Round 3, how to repair skin by cleansing for each skin type. First of all, remember that excessive cleansing is your skin barrier's biggest enemy. Cleansing twice a day, in the morning and in the evening, is enough to remove any impurities that pile up during the day. So let's find out how different skin types should cleanse in order to repair the skin barrier. For sensitive skin, we recommend using micellar water in the morning and an oil cleanser in the evening. Your skin is already sensitive enough as it is, and if the skin barrier is damaged, cleansing with water that has a high pH may be a lot for your skin to handle. So substitute regular cleansing with micellar water and use an oil cleanser with a hydrating finish in the evening, because sensitive skin types tend to be really dry. Is your skin dry in the morning and in the evening? Then we recommend that you use an oil or a balm type of cleanser twice a day. Oil-based cleansers will leave your skin feeling the most hydrated. If you have combination skin, try using an oil-based cleanser in the morning and a gel type of cleanser in the evening. By using a gel cleanser, which has a strong cleansing ability than an oil cleanser, you can care for the oily parts of your skin at the end of the day. If you have oily skin similar to combination skin, use an oil-based cleanser in the morning and a gel type of cleanser in the evening. Gel cleansers are effective for removing sebum, so if you have healthier skin, it's okay to use a gel cleanser twice a day. But in order to protect the acid mantle, try using a more gentle oil cleanser along with it. So let's keep strengthening our skin barrier more and more by cleansing correctly. You don't have to follow the cleansing routines exactly like we suggested today, but make sure that you keep these tips in mind when choosing a right cleanser for your routine to protect your acid mantle and even repairing your damaged skin barrier furthermore. In the next video, we will talk about moisturizing ingredients that help to repair the skin barrier. So please look forward to that and stay tuned in. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and we will see you next time. Bye, Wishtrenders!